Got a dead book dealer, a killer lawyer, and a bunch of worthless books. All right, come on. As a reformed professional counterfeiter, what is the Dutchman's interest in these?
Published 1944 in Madrid. This is what he's after.
The top sheet?
More than that. This is a piece of 1944 Spanish press parchment.
That's what he wanted. Good. This is good.
He's gonna counterfeit something that was originally printed on paper like that.
That's what I would do.
Tony made three prior shipments with these.
Two blank pages per book is 600 sheets.
Too many for paintings, not enough for currency. I bet our dead book dealer knew. Diana, where's that wallet?
It's right here.
This is where he went the day before he left for Spain.
Yeah, I do remember him. He came by several months ago, and then again last week. This is what he came to see. The Spanish victory bond. He took several photographs of it, said he was going to write a book. It's a shame he's dead. This bond does have a fascinating history.
It's a Goya.
Yes. Beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, look at that. A perfect fit. You're starting to earn your $700 a month.
You said it had a fascinating history.
Quite. It was issued during the war.
1944?
Yes. Yeah, the U.S. issued it to support the Spanish underground in their battle against the Axis. Very few have ever been redeemed. There's speculation that entire boxes were captured, and many of them are still hidden away in the caves of Altamira.
Full boxes of these?
Yeah. Boy, that would be something, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
This is the only surviving copy.
Except it's a forgery.
Right. That's not possible.
What are you talking about?
It's the ink. This is iron gall dye mixed to match period colors, but it hasn't dried yet. You can still smell the gum Arabic.
No, this has been here since 1952.
It's been here less than a week.
Okay. Tony makes two trips. The first time, he takes a picture of the bond. His second trip in, he steals the original and replaces it with this copy. Can we confirm that?
The timed ink identification test puts the age of the bond at approximately 6 days, which coincides with Tony's visit.
We're pulling surveillance video to back it up.
Good. So the question is, why go to the trouble of making a really nice forgery on the right kind of paper just to stick it back in the archives?
Is the bond still negotiable?
It's a zero option, so it never expires. What's it worth?
$1,000 face value. Drawing 9% interest.
Compounded for 64 years.
$248,000.
What he said?
Quarter of a million, not chump change. And he's got 600 sheets of the stuff.
150 million, give or take.
Be a rich man if he could pass them off. But it still doesn't tell us why he would take out the real bond and put in a forgery.
I think it does. What if he claimed he found boxes of the original bonds?
Dragged them out of those caves in Spain.
Yeah, how would they be authenticated?
They'd be taken to the archives and compared to the original.
Which he's already switched out with one of his own copies.
So of course they're gonna match. Oh, this is good. This is really good. All right, let's think about this.